गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग टॉपिक. सो एट द फर्स्ट टॉपिक वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आदित्य एंड आर्थर. दे वेंट टू देयर नेटिव ब्रह्मपुर टू विजिट द स्कूल एंड द ओल्ड हाउस. देयर हाउस इज 200 इयर्स ओल्ड हाउस. इट वॉज देयर एंसेस्टर्स, आदित्यस एंसेस्टर्स होम, एंड दे हैड डिसाइडेड टू हैव अ कप ऑफ टी एट द नॉयन्स अंकल शॉप. Let us see what they whether now the Noyan uncle had inquired who they are and why they had came from where they had came from and for what purpose they had came. Let us see what they had replied. To have tea at your shop. So Noyan uncle asked them why they had came here. It's just Aditya had replied to have a tea at your shop, to drink a tea at there. Certainly, beside the tea, I have a biscuit and the sovereigns. Sovereigns means simply it is a hot smell, hot taste, காரமாக இருக்கிறது பேர் சோவரைட்ஸ். கிவ் மீ டு நான்கடைஸ். நான்கடைஸ் மீன்ஸ் இட்ஸ் அ பிஸ்கட் டைப், என்ன சொல்லுவாங்க, ரூஸ்பெரிஸ் சொல்லுவோம்ல, அதுதான் நான்கடை. ஓகே, சி வி சாட் ஆன் த டூ டின் சேர்ஸ் வேர் தேர் வாஸ் ஒன்லி ஒன் அனதர் கஸ்டமர் சிட்டிங் அட் த கார்னர் டேபிள் எய்தர் ஈட்டிங் ஆர் ட்ரிங்கிங் டீ. But sitting is his head bent as thought he was sleeping. So there is a two thin chairs are there. They are sitting there and the customers are sitting in the customer. Only one customer is sitting at the corner of the table, either eating nor drinking. Simply he is sitting there without eating or drinking. But sitting at his head bent as through he was sleeping. He thought he was sleeping. He is not drinking anything, not eating anything, simply he is keeping his head down and it makes us to see that he was sleeping. Addressing him is a Sanjal. Nayan uncle reminded him to go to home as it was already 4 o'clock. So now Nayan uncle is making him allot to go to home because it is 4 o'clock. Another customer could come soon be coming. Addressing as he said with a wink in his eyes, the little heart of hearing, the little heart to hear cannot see well either, but has no money to buy spectacles. So addressing as he said, it's wrink his eyes. Simply wrinkling means அப்படி கண் அடிக்கிறது. A little hard to hearing. அவருக்கு என்னது, he can't able to hear. He is hearing impaired. He can't able even to see also. Even he don't have money to buy any spectacles. From this reactions to the speech, I began to wonder whether Mr. Sanjal was not little crazy as well, because suddenly he stood up and scratched himself and the raised his lean right arm and with his eyes dilated began to recite a poem by Tagore, Panraksha. Having recited the poem, he left the place making the gesture of namaste with his hands to nobody in particular. So what happened? From his reaction to his speech, I began to wonder whether Mr. Sanjal was not little crazy as well. So crazy means he has some mentally disorder. He is not that much sure. He is wondering. So he have a doubt whether he is crazy because he has stood up suddenly and he stretched himself and raising his lean right arm. He is raising his lean right arm and his eyes dilated. Dilated means he's not usually, it means he's opening his eyes widely. Kannavadi morachi pakaradu, that is. Began to recite a poem by Tagore. He is reciting a poem, that's a Panraksha poem. It's keeping of the promise. The name of the poem, the theme of the poem is keeping of a promise. How to keep a promise. So he is reciting the poem. Having recited the poem, he left the place making a gesture of namaste. Kaiya uttu kumbola, that is namaste. So he is telling namaste. He is not particularly pointing anyone. Simply he said namaste and he went away from the place. I noticed a sudden change in Aditya's expression and asked him for the reason for it. Without answering me, he asked Nayan uncle who the gentleman was and what he did. So now he noticed, Arthur had noticed a sudden change there in the face of Aditya, and he asking for the reason, without answering his question, he started to inquire about the man who was to the Nayan uncle. The Nayan uncle replied, Sasanga Sanjal. Its name is Sasanga Sanjal. who can be done? He lived to the cursed life, gone crazy, I think, but has not forgotten any incident of the past. Sold his land to get his only daughter married. He lost his wife and the only son last year. Since then, he is somewhat changed. It's not normal, really normal. Where does he stayed? So now the Narayan uncle replied, he was a Sasanga Sanjal. His name is Sasanga Sanjal, and he was gone crazy. He went mad because he is leading a cursed life. Cursed life means not good life. That is a cursed life. And he gone crazy. I think, but he had not forgotten any past incident. He had not forgotten. He can remember all the incident which has happened to him in the past. In his old, he had sold his land for his making his only daughter to get married. And he lost his wife and the only son last year. At last year, he had lost his wife as well as his only son. Since he had somewhat changed, so he was changed because there is a depression in his mind. Not really normal. He is not a normal man. Where does he stay? Now Aditya asked about where he was staying. He stayed with his friend of his father, Jogesh Kabilraj. So he is staying with Jogesh Kabilraj. He is a friend of his father. Sasanga came here, has tea and biscuit, and always remembered to pay, having the acute sense of self-respect. But how long thing will remain like this, I don't know. So now Sasanga, Nayan uncle is telling about Sasanga. He came there and he will have a tea and the biscuit. If he will pay, he won't forget to pay the bill also. He is paying, and it won't. He is having an acute sense of self-respect. He is giving more important for his self-respect. But how long things will remain like this, I don't know. So now Arthur is the Nayan uncle is doubtful how long it will go. He don't know how long he will lead this life in this way. Having paid our bill and ascending a location of the Jogesh Kabilraj house, we got into the car. Aditya was at the wheel. He expressed his wish to visit his house. So you do you want to see your house after all, I said. So while he is ready to find the Jogesh Kabilraj house, on the way he want to see his old house. So he went there. It has become essential to do so, Aditya replied. So Aditya said, now it is very important for him to visit his old house. He now seems overthought. Overthought means he is very upset for some reason. We soon reached the house, which was surrounded by the high wall. So he went to the house. The house is surrounded by the high walls. Even from the ruins, one could easily imagine how grand it must have been once upon a time. Ruin means destroyed. Idubadugal. Even the house was destroyed, it was not good in condition. Even we can imagine how grand the house was once upon the time. So by seeing the appearance of the house itself, we can imagine the grandness of the house in the olden days. We enter the building, climb up the stair and reach the attic on the second floor of the house. So they had reached the attic through the stairs. This was my favorite room, said Aditya. The attic has been always the favorite with the children. It is in the attic that the child seems to be in the world of its own. So he is telling the favorite place of him is attic, and the attic is always the favorite place for all the children, because attic is the only place in the world they can do their own work. The position of the wall of the attic had crumbled down. It's broken. Crumbled means broken. And through the window that has been created, it could see the sky, the field, the part of the rice mill, the spire of the old temple. Spire, S-P-I-R, spire means the tower, coil goburam, that is spire. So from the house they had constructed in that way, from the window they can see the field, the sky as the part of the rice mill also. Even they can see the goburam of the temple. In the whole house, the attic has been the worst hit by the wind and the weather. So the attic has a worst hit. Because of the wind and the weather, the attic had destroyed a lot. The floor was strings with the wings and the straws of the pigeon dropping. So the floor was strews, and the pigeon pura wood and the itchellam potrukola adu and the kuchi ella illa kadakku. Among the other thing, there was a broken cricket bat, the remain of the armchair and the wooden packing case. So the only one thing is there, that is a wooden broken cricket bat is there, and the remaining the armchair is there and the wooden packing case. Oru mara petti irukku. Aditya got on the top of the packing case and pushed his hand inside the ventilator, and thus upsetting the sparrow nest, a part of which fell onto the ground. However, he heaved a sigh of relief that he had got what he had been looking for. So he had on the top of the packing sheet, he put his hand onto the ventilator and he disturbed the sparrow nest, and he had seen something there on the ventilator. When I asked him what it was, he said, "You will come to know, very soon." So he had not replied simply. He said, "You come to know very soon." We next went to the jewelry to make out the weight of the article. So they went to the jewelry shop to find the weight of the article, which is found out in the attic. The jewelry remarked that it was an antique. Antique means old collection of the gold or silver. Our next shop was the house of the Jogesh Kabilraj. It was a little curious. I don't ask Aditya anything. So next house is Jogesh Kabilraj house is there. So he was very curious. Even he had not asked anything to the Aditya. We entered the house and went to the room where the Sasanga Sanjal stayed. So they entered the room and they entered the house and went to the room where the Sasanga Sanjal stayed. Sasanga uncle was busy reciting the verses from the Tagore. He is reciting the poem of the Tagore. When he had finished, Aditya asked, "May we come in?" He turned and faced us. So now Aditya is seeking permission of Sanjal to enter into his room. "No one visit me," he said in the unperturbed manner. So undisturbed manner he is saying. No one had visited him. "Could you mind if we come in?" He is asking. Any problem for them? For them to enter? "Come in," he said. "Except for the chapari." Charpoy, it means kite, the cot which is made up of some wires. Kite kattil nam solluvanga adha charpoy. Only the charpoy is there. There was nothing else to sit on, so we remained standing. So nothing is there for them to sit, so they are standing. "Do you remember Aditya Narayan Chaudhary?" Aditya asked him. So Aditya asked Sanjal whether he can remember the Aditya Narayan Chaudhary. "Of course," said the gentleman. "He was a spoiled child of the affluent parents. Was a very good student, but could never beat me. He was extremely jealous of me, and he used to tell lie." How he had explained? See, he was the spoiled child of the affluent parent. Affluent parent, nalla panakara parent ala kedukapatta kulanda. That is a affluent parent. "Was a very good student, nalla paiyan, but won't never beat me." So he can't able to compete Sanjal in his school studies. "He extremely jealous of me." So the Aditya is extremely jealous of Sanjal. "And he was used to tell lie." How he used to say lies? "I know," said Aditya. Then he took out the packet from his pocket and handing it over to him, said, "This is for you," from Aditya. So he had taken the pocket and given to him one small pocket. "This is for you," from Aditya. "What is it?" he asked. "Money." "Money? How much money?" 150 rupees. He has said that it was happy if you accept it. "Shall I laugh or cry? Aditya has given me money. Why this sudden generosity? Man does change with time. Perhaps Aditya is not the same as before." So now Aditya had given some money to him and he is asking what it is. "It is money," Aditya replied. "And how much money is there?" "It is 150 rupees is there." And he was 50 rupees is there. And he said what he had to do, whether he had to laugh or he had to cry, because Aditya had given money to me. So why he is asking, Sanjal is asking to Aditya, why there is a sudden generosity? Why he got a sudden generosity? The generosity means nothing. Dharala manapan. Why he got it? "The man does change his time." Manishan gera the kaala irathi enna pannum maathu. Ana Aditya modala madri illa. It means perhaps Aditya is not the same Aditya as before. Aditya is not as what he was in the childhood. It means I change. I got the price. I could not bear it. He took it from me to show his father. Never returned it to me. Said that was a hole in his pocket, that it had fallen through it. So the change. I got a price. He got a price, and he he could not bear it. The price which is got by the Sanjal can't able to bear it, because Aditya said that he will take the price and show it to their parents and he will return it back to Sanjal. But he had not returned. He had said the story that there is a hole in his pocket, it dropped down from the pocket. Appa enadhu or price Sanjal kadachirukke, Sanjal kadacha price enadhu Aditya solraru, na enga appa kitta kaatittu kondu vandu kudukuren appingana, ana kudukala edukna enoda pocket la or hole inda hole valiya enna pannidichi keela vindirchi appdi solraru. This is the price of the medal, it's yours. So now Aditya is giving the price of the medal, the amount of what is the medal consists of. He is giving the price of the medal to them. Sanjal Sasanga Sanjal was amazed and he stared at Aditya and said, the price of the medal, that could be more than 5 rupees. It was a silver medal, so the value of the silver medal is only 5 rupees. So he is not ready to get the 150 rupees. The silver is now 30 times costlier than before. So now the value of the silver rises for 30 times, increased for 30 times costlier. Really, I have no news of that. But Sasanga uncle looked at the 15 10 rupees note in his hand and then to look at Aditya. There was a complete new expression on his face. He said, Aditya, this match too much of charity, doesn't it? So he is telling, by seeing the currency in the hand of the Aditya, because he have a 15 10 rupees notes in his hand, he say the Sanjal uncle had seen the note as well as Aditya face, and he said it is a there is a new expression in his face, and he said it is too much of charity, kudukuradhukku idu alavillaya idu nareya abdin. He remained silent, peering intently at the Aditya and the Sanjal. Sasanga Sanjal smiled and said, I had recognized you at the Nahan uncle's tea shop by the mole on your right cheek. I could see you had you not recognized me, so I recited the same poem that I had recited on the prize giving day on the purpose so that you may remember. Then when you come to visit me, I couldn't help venting my anger on you. So Sasanga had replied that he had identified the Aditya at the Nayan uncle shop itself, because on the he has a mole na macho on the right side of the cheek. By seeing that, he had find out, Sanjal had find out the Aditya. The Aditya had not recognized him, that's why he had recited the same poem, which is the poem which is recited by him on the prize giving day. So he had recited the same poem to make him to remember that is a Sanjal. So when they enter the room, he can't able to show the venturing of anger and kovatham mela katha mudiyala, he can't help. You have done the right thing, your grievance are absolutely justified, but I will be happy if you accept the money, said Aditya. So now Aditya is telling, it's real, nana irundhal enna pannuven appadi dhaan seivan, your grievance onna varutham undu justify unmaikuriya dhaan appdi solrar, but I will be happy if you accept the money, said Aditya. Aditya said that if he accept the money only, that Aditya will become happy. Sasanga Sanjal shook his head and they said, no, money will soon be spent. I would have preferred to have the medal if it were possible. I have forgotten that the unpleasant incident of my childhood, if I could get the medal back. So he refused to take the money. He need only the medal, because it will help him to forget the bad memory which is incident happened in his past. So the medal has been hidden in the attic for 29 years, was evidently restored to its owner. So even actually restored to his owner. So after the 29 years the medal was stored in the attic. Now it went to the original owner, the original possessor of the medal. So he had given the medal to the Shriman Sasanga Sanjal special prize for the recitation 1948 was still clearly engraved on it. So the name, his name, Shriram Sasanga Sanjal, it's a special prize which is given to him at the year of 1948. It's still clearly engraved on it. It means adha nalla eludhirukku, clearly we can see. This story is translated from the Bengali story Chilikota. It's a Bengali story, Chilikota. They have translated in English. So it is a very good story, and from this lesson we have to learn, we should not take others' thing. we should not possess the thing which belongs to other. Definitely it will create a bad impression on you. So what are the things which we are doing in our schooling, it will give a identity for us. So while in the schooling or even in your childhood, you try to commit good things, you don't commit any bad things in your life. Thank you, my dear students. Go through the part 1 and the part 2 of this story for your better understanding. Go through the glossaries which is given in your book. At the next class, we will discuss about the compound words which is given in your vocabulary section. Thank you, my dear students.